Have you ever needed to measure people's preferences or attitudes? Have you ever had to prioritize dozens of items, actions, or policies for your organization? Whether you work in the private sector, government, healthcare, economics, psychology, or marketing insights, a simple yet powerful research technique known as best worst scaling, or MaxDiff, could be just what you need in your toolbox. Let's consider Bill, who's looking to open a diner. Bill wants to know what to put on his menu and realizes people have different tastes. Bill could ask respondents to rate main dishes on, say, a 5-point scale. But they typically will register lots of ties, making it hard to discriminate among items. Making matters worse, different respondents will use the scale differently, depending on their cultural backgrounds. Or maybe even their moods that day. Of course, it's really difficult to compare groups of people when they use the same scale differently. Plus, Bill wants to ask respondents to evaluate around 30 potential main dishes, so these grids would be even longer than shown here. Let's demonstrate how best worst scaling, or MaxDiff, can provide a better option. In the 1980s, Jordan Louvier showed three or more items at a time, and respondents picked just the best and the worst. Louvier recognized that people were good at identifying extremes, the best and worst items, so he called it best worst scaling. In this case, if a respondent says a bacon burger is best and pasta marinara is worst, we can infer 5 of the possible 6 paired comparisons from just 2 clicks or taps. Across multiple questions, respondents compare all the items in many different rotations. And the scores from best worst scaling are easy for Bill to interpret, since they can be placed on a ratio scale. Meaning, an 8 on the scale is twice as important or preferred as a 4. Best worst scores show greater discrimination among the items than rating scales, show greater discrimination between respondents than rating scales, are free from scale use bias, and this all means that Bill can get better results with fewer respondents. And Bill's Diner is just one example of the many situations that can benefit from best worst. Great data lead to great decisions. You too can probably think of ways to apply these techniques to solve important problems for your organization. Sawtooth Software has developed easy yet powerful tools to manage the entire process. Once you learn MaxDiff, you're well on your way to learning conjoint analysis. To learn more about MaxDiff, please visit us at sawtoothsoftware.com, the survey software of choice.